Look at that beautiful coach, everybody. Welcome back to the Mothership Marathon Mondays with Mal. That is Coach 1344, an X3 double slide, the latest from Marathon. John's getting a good exterior shot. We're gonna drive it this morning. We're gonna drive it, and it's gonna be a good reveal. Hey, it's me. I'm gonna take this off so you can see what I'm saying. We've gotta be safe though at the same time. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Marathon Mondays with Mal. Coach 1344, everybody. I'm excited to show you this. This is the latest from Marathon. X3 double slide, beautiful floor plan, and it's a great coach. So come on in. Let's drive it around the parking lot, put the slides out, and take a look at the floor plan. Check my mirrors. Here we go. Lane departure warning system is enabled. We're just gonna roll around the parking lot. Hope everyone had a good weekend. Hope everyone is being safe and doing what it is that they need to do to be safe as the pandemic continues, right? Doing what we do. Building. Beautiful coaches, 1344 X3 double slide. I love this floor plan. Wait till we get into it. There's a couple of things that John pointed out to me before we went live. That rear closet door is really pretty. So we're gonna get back there. We're gonna throw these two slides out and take a look at it. But I just wanted to drive it around the building. This coach is still for sale. It's one of the only ones. New coaches that we do have for sale right now. Coaches are selling as inventory is an interesting thing right now in the industry. And look at that old Volkswagen Bug. Someone's got a Super Beetle out here, you guys. This looks like a burnt orange, reddish. Someone from our paint team's got a little Super Beetle. I like it. How many of you guys had a Super Beetle? I know Richard Lawrence is watching. Richard, did you have a Super Beetle in your day or a Bug? I've had a couple. It was my wife's first car. Service department looks pretty busy. Boy, I tell you, someone's got a Harley on the back of their, mounted on the back of their coach. That's pretty cool. Camp Marathon's been busy. You know, that's just it. Service departments at all three of our locations are really busy right now, you guys. Florida, Texas, and of course here in Coburg at the Mothership. If you need to get your coach, we're gonna drive through Camp Marathon here, you guys, so you can see all these beautiful coaches. If you are looking to get into service, you should make an appointment. That's one of the best things you can do to help yourself out. It also helps out our service departments. There's 1187 waiting for its new owners. They're on their way back from their trip. So if you're looking to make a pretty coach. If you're looking to get into our service department, what I'm trying to say here, scatterbrained a little bit, is make an appointment. It'll really help you out so that you're not sitting around waiting because we are really booked at all three locations. Here's a really good shot of, there's 1250, which is sold. There's 1265, which is sold. There's a 40 footer in there. That guy's got a deposit on it. There's a new shell down there. We're gonna pull right up to the front. Put these slides out. Let's pull right in here, the front of the corporate office here, and get a good look at this coach. Always fun to drive one of these coaches on video for you. All right. Put it in neutral. I'm gonna roll this window down. when you're putting your slide outs out, you want to make sure you either have your coin window down or your entry door out, and that helps with the vacuum of the seal of these slide outs. So we're going to put the first slide out. I'm going to move around you here, John, without losing that. So in the salon here, I'm just going to hold this guy out. I'm going to take a physical look and make sure that there is nothing in the way. Brand new coach. This coach just completed. That beautiful floor. Fireplace behind the driver. Jackknifing sofa. I really like the fabric on that dinette. Let's put out this area rug here. Look at that. Get that properly centered. Very nice. And let's go put the, the ceiling is great too. We're gonna get to the ceiling too. Just give me a few minutes. We're gonna get to the rear of the coach here. John's making his way. And right inside here, we're gonna put the rear driver's side slide out all the way out, and you'll see how much room is created in the coach. A lot of people are very, very surprised when they initially see it go from, I mean, everything is accessible when the slides are in, but when the slide outs go out, you just get a really good idea of how much room is created by that slide out going out. All right, let's start in the back of the coach. Since we always like to start in the front, we're gonna start in the back. And there's that beautiful door, really pretty. I also like how the recessed frame is exposed when that door is closed. Gives it a nice finished look. One of the things about this floor plan is storage. And I really like this. You guys know that I do. This header changing from the fold up or fold back shelving cabinetry. It now has this pull down, which it looks like just a header until you actually realize it's got storage there. That's cool. All right, let's open the closet now so you can get that full effect of this rear closet. And then one of the things, you know, I'll show you this, you guys. That folds back like that, which is nice. The rear closet is large. You guys know that I'm 5'11", 6 foot, what have you, and I'm standing in here. So you can actually get up in here, audio visual over here, and also lots of room to place items for your closet. Large dog-legged L-shaped hanger bar above. And then just on the back side here, there's a 1 foot hanger bar, and you can see it up there. That's for long hang. But don't worry, there's much more closet space in this coach. Of course, stacking Asco's washer dryer. But as you can see, I can stand here at 6 foot tall in the entry or the exit of this closet. So that's very cool. Storage above and below the bed, as you saw, and lots of storage underneath the television here and on both sides. So on both sides, you're gonna have shelves, and these shelves are removable and adjustable. So you can set the pins the way you want it, get it in there, and place it to the exact specifications of where you would like your items to fit. All right, I'm gonna switch spots with you, John. I'll have you come back over here. And I'm gonna show you on the forward side of the bed. For you nautical guys, you'll give me a different term. Hanging closet here, right before you get to the bed, very deep. That's nice. That's a 2 foot hanger bar. And of course, you've got these four drawers here, and these are long, guys. Look how long that is. You got four of that dimension. One of the things I'm gonna show you is, and John, if you want to come over on this side, you'll get a good look at this beautiful drawer. One of the things I like to highlight on every coach is that beautiful drawer. Different colors in every coach, and of course it's got the Marathon Coach logo burned into the corner. This is one of the things I really like to highlight when I'm showing a coach, whether it be on video or in person. These are tongue and groove bamboo, very well built drawers. And they come in different colors, and they're very, very good looking, and they're very, very solid. And I love the Marathon logo embossed into each one. Let's take a look at the water closet. The backsplash really stands out because of the shower. It plays right off of the shower. I'm gonna open this door here for you, John. Let you take a look at that shower. Look at the shower caddy also, how it matches the Corian trim. It's just a really, really nice coach. Good earth tones in this one, but it's also kind of got a modern, and maybe that's the wrong term to say modern, but it's definitely, I don't know what Alan would say if it's, or Brenda or Santara, they would say, is it contemporary modern? Is it transitional? I'll tell you what, I really like it though. Storage above and below the vanity here, lots and lots of room, and lighting. One of the things about our water closets is we also have indirect lighting or ambient lighting in there, and there's also storage for linens behind the commode. Very cool. Now, I'm gonna show you this configuration. This is really cool. So the first thing you got here is the check me mirror on the inside, but you also have a large closet with large drawers. You see that Blu-ray player is in there too, so that's cool. All right. We're gonna open this drawer. Come on over on this side, John. So this is the art door. I wanna make sure I get the right. Behind the art door is the bath, the half bath. Take a look at that, you guys. It's kind of like a hidden door, as you've seen before, but it's just a beautiful, beautiful half bath. I love the wall covering. This is really, really nice. There's nothing gaudy about this coach. It's just really, really pretty. And then let's close the water closet. And when you're walking through here, you can't really tell that's a water closet, and you have to utilize it with a button to get into it. So that's really great. X3, so you know you were gonna have that Sub-Zero refrigerator. The new Sub-Zero is, I've already said this before on video, I love the lighting. And of course you got the double tiered freezers below. Take a look at this pantry. There's more of those beautiful drawers. Lots of pantry space in here. And these are fully adjustable also. All right. Convection microwave oven with storage above, but also it goes behind cabinetry to give you a really nice closed look. Storage above and below. You're gonna have a dish drawer in there. You're gonna have your range top here, which is induction, of course. But look, if you can see it on video, and I hope that you can, there's two things I wanna point out here. Look at the gloss of that. It's not high gloss, but it does have a little bit of a polish to it. Really, really pretty. I love how the speckles really show in this Corian countertop. But the other thing that really stands out to me is this raised lip all the way around the entire galley countertop. No water is getting on your floor with that type of a lip. I really like that design. And take a look. So the countertop has a gloss to it, but look at the inside of the continuation Corian sink. It's got a flat finish in there, but I like how it's the transition just goes right from the countertop into the sink. Very pretty. Okay, back over on the driver's side, dinette. Of course, you guys know not only does it move in and out with a little motor over here, but it also pivots so that the owners can get in and out easier. That's something that really stands out as far as user-friendly storage below, above, and as you know, behind when it comes to the dinette. Want to point out all the natural light that is here in the salon. Curio cabinets in coaches, as of right now, you'll see in a lot of our floor plans, the curio cabinets have kind of gone away. We do have these displays that are up here in the uppers, but no more curios. Like this used to be a curio. And right now, look at how much natural light comes in there. Look at the other side. You'll see all kinds of natural light. Here's the TV in the salon. Comes out so it moves so that you'll be able to watch TV from any angle, thank you. Any angle in the salon, which is nice. And of course, you've got this natural light coming through here, no curios. You've got the ambient intelligence in this coach, which is a really cool feature, the ability to work with your air condition, your lighting, your audio visual, just through your voice. You can even lock the entry door, which is a great feature, because if you're sitting here enjoying your dinner and you forgot, if you locked your entry door, you can just do it with your voice to make sure that it's locked. Jackknifing sofa. I love the brown leather on this one. I don't have to say enough because I say it all the time, but we're going to say it one more again. Our upholstery team, best in the business. Absolutely beautiful stuff. That's a handmade jackknifing sofa. Storage behind it also. On the other side, which is the curbside, also known as the patio side, you've got this recliner here with the croc inserts, storage below and behind, an occasional table, and of course, you know it's got the cocktail. This is something we don't show enough of. Look at that. It just extends your occasional table out a hair, just so you can see. Abigail, if you wanna switch sides with me. I really love the detail of that and the ability to have that. It just extends it out. And then as you know, in an X3, your cockpit and your living quarters are on the same level. That's one of the benefits of it. Also, you get that higher ceiling. So this co-pilot seat spins all the way around, or it pivots and swirls so that it can become part of the salon. If you need extra seating in your salon, you've got it right here. Large TV, of course, that comes down over the cockpit. One of the things that I really like about this coach is that ceiling. I mentioned it at the top of the show. This ceiling is my favorite ceiling. This is not a ceiling that will ever go out of style. Now that is backlit. John, I'm gonna walk right by you and I'm gonna mess with some lighting. Center ceiling lights off. Take a look at that. Center ceiling lights on. Now watch this. I can dim them by holding that button down. I don't know if that shows up in the camera, but you can dim it, and then just by holding it down, it pops back up. So you can have it on, you can have it off. Very versatile, and as you can see, It has the traditional puck lights, which are of course are LEDs, and then of course it's got the indirect lighting or the accent lighting all over the coach, not just around the ceiling, but around the stiles, the valances, and underneath in some kick plate areas of the galley. You know, that's the important stuff. Audio visual, lighting, those are the things that when it is 9 o'clock at night and you're watching Steve McQueen Bullet and you're enjoying this amazing car chase halfway through the movie, you want good audio sound, and this coach has it. One of the things that I've done before to really demonstrate it, and we can't and won't do it on video because it doesn't hold it well enough on video, is I put an acapella version of the Beach Boys singing, and we stand right where John and I are standing here in the middle of the coach. And the sounds of Brian Wilson and Mike Love as you're standing right here in the middle of the coach is incredible. And what that comes down to is the proper engineering of the system and the placement and the execution of the install. So there's a lot of pieces that go together to bring a good audio visual, but also the lighting. When it's 9 o'clock at night and you're watching McQueen, you want to have good lighting. Turn off all the lights except the TV, and you've got a fireplace down here. The fireplace adds a really cool indirect light, and it adds to the ambiance of the scenario, but also it puts out really nice and safe electric heat. So with the heated floors in here, you might not even turn your heaters on ever. So four roof airs if you need it. If you need to cool down, you got those four roof airs. John, I'm gonna have you move forward and I'm gonna talk behind you. Take a look at that cockpit, you guys. This is another thing that stood out about this coach. This dark chocolate brown of the leather, which flows not only from the seats, but also onto the panels of the door and the entry dashboard. John's gonna get over there and show you that, but the dash, the cockpit, everything is in this beautiful cream leather. So it's a bright cockpit, but it's also enhanced by the dark brown of the leather seating. It's just really, really well done. Abigail, do you know who designed this one?
I'm not aware.
Shame on me, I should know.
I was also looking at the chairs. I think they're beautiful.
This coach is just put together well, whether it was Alan, Brenda, or Santara. What a beautiful coach, and they probably worked as a team. Our design team, they worked together on almost every coach anyway, so there's a lot of input, and that is a very strong department within Marathon, kind of like we showed you about our upholstery earlier. That is Coach 1344, and it's for sale. It's one of the only coaches that Marathon has for sale from a new standpoint. We do have some really nice consignments out there, you guys. So if you're looking to get into a coach, this is gonna be one that I want you to look at. This is the latest from Marathon, 1344. It's an X3 double slide, a 2022 Marathon. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for this tour. Hold on, John just looked at me like, hey, wait a minute, we have something else. Abigail, is there any questions, any comments? Should we walk? It's kind of loud outside. I wanted to walk outside and show the exterior one more time. We can do that at the end of the show. Give me some comments and questions. I see a customer going out there with his grandson. Looks like he's got a Nerf gun. Very cool. He's going to keep us all protected.
He does.
I like it.
Our good friend Jim Torrance has been helping us answer a couple questions, but he said, do you have to have internet connection to use the ambient voice?
Yeah, that's a good question. Every coach over the last several years has internal Wi-Fi, has Wi-Fi that is strictly for this coach. So yes, to utilize the ambient intelligence, you have to and would want to have Wi-Fi. That's the way it is quick and efficient. And so to get a quick and efficient response from the coach, it has to be based on the Wi-Fi. And so yes, the answer is yes. And before I forget, malw@marathoncoach.com is my email. If you're looking, I mean, you guys know that I'm a salesman here. So if you're looking to get into a coach, or if you just have questions, feel free to reach out to me.
Our good friend Gerald Bennett says, and this is a good segue into going outside.
Sure.
What about the outdoor entertainment? Is the audio just as loud?
What a great question, and what a good guy to ask it, someone who's been with us since day one and a good friend of the show. So thanks, Gerald. Let's go outside. I'm going to show you the entertainment bay in this coach and get into that very briefly. So let's head on outside. John's gonna do the Ginger Rogers as he walks backwards, hopefully not falling. I've seen worse. Okay, gonna unlock the bay. Take a look at this. So this is your entertainment bay in the X3. Very large 4K Samsung smart TV. Underneath is a sound bar. Because you're outside, the audio sound is going to be, of course, different than the calibration and the engineered style of the inside audio. But I will say this, that sound bar does wonders outside a coach. Here we are, literally 50 yards from Interstate 5, and if I turned that on, we would be able to listen to a game or a talk show or anything where you really wanted to hear commentary or the audio. That sound bar does wonders. So the sound that you're gonna get from the patio is very, very good in a marathon, whether that be the X3 like this one or the H3. And it's all because of the sound bar. It's a very, very good sound. Here's a good shot of that entry door. Good colors. We build the best coaches in the world, you guys. I think you know that. Building on the Prevost chassis is one thing, because the Prevost chassis is the best chassis to build a luxury RV on, and Marathon does the most and the best in the world. Feel free to reach out to me, malw@marathoncoach.com. Thank you so much for hanging out with me this morning. Be yourself and do good things. Have a good week, be safe, and let me know if you want to get into 1344. What a beautiful coach. All right, take care, you guys.